So anyways, I tell them, yes, I'll go on to PNN, and they put me in this place. Where in the world are we? PNN? Seriously? Oh, we're wrong? Sorry. Hello, I am Ron Burgundy, and I'm here for the Penn News Network, PNN.
And I'm Veronica Corningstone, and here is your news for the 1st of November. If you are taking SAT this Saturday at Mishawaka High School, then you will need your picture ID and admission ticket. Cell phones are not allowed. The doors will open at 7:30. The Writing Center will not be open from November 4th to November 18th due to taking acuity tests online. Please use the IMC to obtain study hall passes instead.
This year's first student town hall meeting will be November 13th from 3:30 to 4:30 in the LGIB, where I would like to invite Miss Veronica to a little bit of dancing. Huh? Huh?
Mr. Huh? Burgundy, I am a professional. I would like to be able to do my job.
I am very professional.
You are, Mr. Burgundy, acting like a baby.
I am a man. An anchor man. On Tuesday, November 5th, the Spanish Club will be having a Day of the Dead. There'll be a lot of crafts, foods, and fun. Now, why would you guys have me say that? I don't speak Spanish. Anyways, we'll go to my main man, Champ Kind. Give us a little bit of sports, Champ.
Champ here, and I'm all about having fun. Go to SeaWorld, take my shirt off. Anyway, I'm kind of known for my catchphrase, whammy! I tend to, whammy! Now about the girls' volleyball team. Girls, what in the world is diversity? Is diversity some old wooden ship that was used during the Civil War era? Anyway, even after a hard-fought game, Lake Central still came out on top of the Lady Kingsmen. Penn finished the season with an overall record that was 29-7, with Sarah Ross leading with 36 kills and Cassidy Meese following behind with 27 kills. Alyssa Wisegat with 93 assists. Great season, Lady Kingsmen. Then we have the girls' cross-country team. They're on their way to Terre Haute to go for the championship. Here's Penn reporter Grace Miller with some of the deets.
On Saturday, November 2nd, our girls' cross-country team will be running for the state title at the Gibson Championship cross-country course in Terre Haute, Indiana. We got the opportunity to speak with runners from each grade about their goals for this Saturday.
Well, we just want to do the best that we can do and get up on the state podium this year. And just we have a really good team, and so we have a good chance of doing really well. We just want to do our best.
As a team, we really want to, like, get in the top 10, like, be one of those teams, get on the podium, not just, like, for us as a team, but also for our senior, Lauren Potchman, who's been leading us all year. And an individual goal is to make it in the top 20 finishers, which is All-States team, and I'm working hard.
My team goals are for us to be on the podium. That means that we'd be one of the top 5 teams in the state. It's something that we are certainly capable of. It's just going to take a good day, but I think it's possible. And my individual goals are to be top 3 at state.
Our team individual goals this season is to do our best and finish in the top 10, try and get the podium spot at state this weekend.
The girls also discussed who their top competition will be.
Definitely Carmel and probably Carroll.
Carmel is the next biggest, like, big school like us, and they're a really competitive team. They're considered the best runner school in the nation, so it's kind of nerve-wracking that we're racing up against them, and we're hoping to, like, knock down a lot of teams and hurting their scores and ultimately getting up there on the podium.
There's a girl from Carmel named Kelsey Welch who I'd like to key off of during the race. There's also Malika Abramson of Avon, Mackenzie Caldwell, and I mean, I'm sure there's other girls. There's always girls out there who you wouldn't expect to be up with you, and they are. So those are the ones I'm expecting.
I guess the other teams that are trying to compete for the other podium spots at state this weekend. So like Carmel's number one right now, and so is West Lafayette is contending for the second place spot and number one. So just those teams. I mean, we're ranked, I think, eighth right now, so just the other teams that are around us.
Good luck to all the girls who will be representing Penn High School this weekend. On behalf of Lauren Okowski, I'm Grace Miller reporting for PNN Sports.
And whammy! That's all we have for you. Now back to the desk.
I love that. Say me one more time. Can I get another whammy?
Whammy!
One more time.
Whammy!
Veronica, give me two. One whammy for me.
Whammy.
No, the chip's one of a kind.
The Penn Ski Club is looking for new members for the 2013-2014 season. They ski at the Swiss Valley Ski Area Tuesday evenings. You can get information and pay your fees for the ski club in the bookstore. You can also see Mr. Robinson, that handsome guy, before school in the tech lab, room 140. Payments are due before Thanksgiving break. No late signups will be accepted. If you are looking to help out others and are a good academic student, then consider signing up to be a freshman tutor in the LGIB during your study hall hour. Please contact Mrs. Watkins in guidance to sign up.
Remember that the Fitness Center is open Monday through Friday from 5:45 a.m. to 7:45 a.m. and then from 3 p.m. to 9 p.m. It's also open on Saturdays from 8 a.m. to noon. This is where I happen to do my lifting. See these guns, Veronica? I didn't think I was going to get into this place. Just give her a touch. Feel these guns.
No.
Feel these guns. Ms. America recently came to visit Penn High School. I got to meet her myself. She's incredible. I mean, she has beautiful hair, beautiful eyes. She actually smelled like cinnamon, Veronica. Cinnamon. Anyways, it looks like there's a bunch of report. These are all women. These are all women. Women don't belong in the newsroom. Champ, what do you think about that?
It's Anchor Man, not Anchor Lady.
It's Anchor Man! Like, there's a scientific fact about that, is there not?
Scientific fact!
Anyways, let's cut to Miss America.
Last Tuesday, October 22nd, the 2014 Miss America winner, Nina Davuluri, visited Penn High School to see the robotics program and to speak to a select few girls in the STEM Academy about their futures. Miss Davuluri explains about her speech to the girls and why studies in STEM are important.
I really hope that it came across as education, really pushing specifically women in science, technology, engineering, and math, speaking about my experiences, as well as kind of motivation, going through the similar experiences that you guys had in high school. We've all been there. So just really having a personal discussion about how I got to where I am today and how everyone can kind of achieve their own goals as well. Education is absolutely the key to success. That's reality, and that's the world we live in, and it's so important to learn those skills from a young age, starting in high school, and continue that throughout college as well.
We also had the chance to ask Miss Davuluri about her pageant career, and she also explained about some of the backlash she faced by winning her title.
They've actually helped a lot because I've learned not only to be balanced in every aspect, but also in terms of my education-wise, scholarship money. So I won $25,000 when I was a teen contestant in the Miss America organization, and then I won $60,000 as Miss America this year. So that amount of money to put towards my education is absolutely incredible.
How has this Miss America experience affected your life?
It has forever changed, and it's really surreal for me to even say that out loud because people will call me Miss America and I don't understand that term yet. So it's been very surreal, but it's very humbling.
You did face a lot of backlash after you won from the people who weren't at the presentation. How did you handle this?
There was a silver lining in the sense that for every one negative tweet or comment or post that I received, I really had hundreds and thousands of words of positive encouragement and love and support from not only Americans, but people from all across the world. And I just truly felt loved in that sense, and people were standing up for Nina, and that was a great message. Yeah.
Here is what Ms. Davuluri wanted to say to Penn students.
Thank you guys for having me. You guys are a great group, so thank you.
For Elaine, Nora, and Casey, I'm Jenny. Now back to the desk.
Thanks, ladies, and way to go out and get that story. We now take you to our weatherman, Britt Tamlin.
Burnt my tongue. Right now it's 61 degrees in our fair school compared to 59 degrees at Mishawaka High School and 51 degrees at St. Joe's. You can expect a sunny day with clouds during the day today. Before we go, I'd like to say a few words. I'm Brick Tamlin. People like me because I'm polite and rarely late. I like to eat ice cream and I really enjoy a nice pair of slacks. Veronica, we're headed back to you.
Thank you, Brick. We're glad to have you on the team. For the entire PNN news team, I'm Veronica Corningstone.
And I'm Ron Burgundy.